Muons are fundamental particles in our universe that are essentially exactly the same as electrons, but heavier, 206.77 times heavier, to be precise. Muons are super fascinating for a number of famous reasons, including, and this is definitely an incomplete list, as an experimental test of time dilation, as a catalyst making fusion possible at room temperature, and that they can be used to make muonic versions of atoms, like muonic hydrogen, with a proton and a muon instead of a proton and electron. But muons themselves decay into an electron and some neutrinos after just a few microseconds on average, which makes them hard to store. So to do experiments on muons, you need to have a source of muons on hand. A small number of muons are produced naturally by cosmic rays striking our atmosphere, but one of the best ways of consistently and reliably making a lot of muons is with a particle accelerator. First, you take hydrogen and you strip off the electrons, leaving you with protons. Then you accelerate the protons really fast in an electric field, or a bunch of electric fields, and crash them into some other atomic nuclei, like lithium or carbon or whatever. The energy of the collision creates a whole mess of particles that goes flying out, but most importantly for our purposes, it creates a particle called a pion, either a pion with a positive electric charge made from an up quark and an anti-down quark, or a pion with negative electric charge made of a down and anti-up quark. If the pions keep traveling in a vacuum so that they don't bump into anything else, they'll spontaneously decay after about 26 nanoseconds, most frequently turning into a muon, which you can use for fusion or testing special relativity or making cool cloud chamber designs. And that's how you make muons. Accelerate protons with enough energy that when they crash into other nuclei, the energy of the collision creates pions, which then decay into muons, which of course, after about 2.2 microseconds, themselves spontaneously decay. If you want to prevent your mind from spontaneously decaying, you may want to check out the new daily math and science problems from this video's sponsor, brilliant.org. To turn keeping your brain sharp into a regular habit, they're now offering fun daily problems, like, what happens when you cut a Möbius strip in half? Can you use a solar sail to crash into the sun? If you bake a loaf of bread that's twice as big, how should you change the temperature and length of time it's in the oven? You can solve these problems and sign up for a new quick question to your inbox every day by going to brilliant.org/minutephysics, which will also give the first 200 people 20% off a premium subscription to Brilliant with access to all of their courses and puzzles and past daily problems. Again, that's brilliant.org/minutephysics to stop your brain from spontaneously decaying.